Live from the venerable grounds of Fenway Park in Boston, Massachusetts, MLB The Show has interleague action for you this afternoon. The Atlanta Braves and the Boston Red Sox. First pitch coming at you right after the break. All right, just about set to go. And towing the slab for the Boston Red Sox in this one, Nick Pivetta.
Well, that 12-6 curveball explodes out of the hand. And because he's able to throw the high fastball at the top of the strike zone for a strike, hitters commit to that pitch. And before they know it, they're swinging over the top of that curveball.
So now to the plate for Atlanta, Ronald Acuna Jr. And a pitch. Out to short, Rafaela. Throws across the diamond. They get the out on Acuna. Here's Brian Snitker's lineup for the Braves. Michael Harris getting ready to hit. Singy, you gotta appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. Up the middle, into the outfield, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit. And now a chance to maybe get creative on offense with good speed on first.
Man at first with one gone, runner on the go. The 1-1 is fouled off. Man at first, one away. Out towards right center field. Abreu sizes this one up. Abreu makes the play.
Batting fourth, the first baseman.
Here's Matt Olson.
Olson.
Harris leads off first with two down to the inning. Pivetta checks the runner.
Now he's in there. He's safe.
At the belt and fires. Oh. Runner on the go. Throw to second. He's safe. Chris's wheels were the difference maker on that play. Just got in there.
Yeah, with StatCast's help, we see his top speed on this stolen base, and that's a big number. I mean, man, he really made his athleticism work for him on that one.
Swing and a foul straight back. Man at second. Hit in the air, center field. Durant has this one sized up. He's there. He's got it. And that is that. Braves strand one. And now the Red Sox get their turn. No score. Back after this on the show. Back here in Boston. And on the hill here today, Spencer Schwellenbach.
Four-pitch guy, he's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance. So we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here and whether or not he's able to mix them all in early or if he wants to hold something back a little bit later, maybe second, third time through the order, and give them something they haven't seen. It's tough when you know a guy's got that in his back pocket. As a hitter, you really have to stay on your toes.
The wide, the kick, and the 1-2. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
No, there's a small sigh of relief right there. I mean, just to keep that speed off the base pass. It's not just the pitcher. It's other guys that have to think about it. From your infielders, have to think about that runner potentially stealing, but also be in position to make a play. As an outfielder, you're thinking about a base hit to the outfield. I got to get to it quickly to try to keep this guy from taking an extra base. So I think everyone just a little more relaxed that he didn't reach base.
Riley racing over to make the catch. As we check out the lineup for the Boston Red Sox. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Oog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
Line drive, Adam in center field. Nothing doing for Boston. Scoreless after one. Second inning set to go. Stepping in, Austin Riley.
Austin Riley.
Swing and a ground ball out to short. Rafaela sends it across to first. Leadoff man retired here in the second.
Yeah, and he looked a little tentative on that swing, almost like he didn't get pitch recognition and tried to slow his bat down just to make contact. I'd rather see a guy swing through it instead of making weak contact and putting it in play, have another pitch where maybe he can drive out of the ballpark.
One down, base is empty.
2-1.
That one fouled off, 2-2. Kicks and fires. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. I know that was a ground ball, but it was absolutely hammered through the infield. That's not one you're excited to get in front of if you're an infielder. You know they used to say, charge it. Crazy.
Here's Orlando Arcia. The shortstop takes the ball.
One strike.
To short, could be two. Off balance feed, there's one. And that's two. One hit in the inning, but no one left. Now to the bottom of the second. We're tied, nothing, nothing. Here at Fenway Leading Park. Off. Now, Willier Abreu.
The right fielder. Willier Abreu.
The pitch. And a good eye there. Swing and a miss. That's strike two. Clyde Washington doing the umpiring behind the dish in this one. Sometimes considered a bit of a pitcher's umpire, Singy.
He likes the low ball, which traditionally favors pitching. But, you know, hitters today are pretty good at dropping their barrel down. So we'll see how it goes in this one.
Out to center. Nice grab on the run. And there's one down. And now it's the catcher for the Red Sox, Connor Wong. Nothing, nothing here in the bottom of the second. Very high with that one. 2-1. Wouldn't chase that time. In the air, out towards right center. Harris sizing this one up. Two down.
Batting fifth. The first baseman.
Dom Smith stands in. Two outs, base is empty. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. Got him swinging. 1, 2, 3 go the Red Sox. We'll move to the third with no score. Back inside Fenway Park, here is Ozzie Albies up to hit.
Albies is playing on the road, so you know that means he's been FaceTiming with his pet fish. This guy owns a few home aquariums, and it's no secret he likes talking to his fish when he's away. In fact, Albies had cameras installed so he can check on the fish anytime he wants.
A wind of the pitch. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout. And now it's Travis d'Arnaud at the plate. That one is hammered right field. Abreu going back to the warning track, makes the catch.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
And here is Ronald Acuna Jr. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. Got it looking. That's a strikeout. Braves are set down 1-2-3, and we are still scoreless. Back here at Fenway, and now it's Garrett Cooper up to hit.
The designated hitter, Garrett.
Is a 1-1. And there's a ball. And another ball. Next offering is in for a strike.
And boy, that was the pitch. 3-1. You want to be really aggressive on the fastball.
This one in the air right field. Acuna on the run. High bounce takes it over the fence. That's an automatic double.
Well, this tends to happen more often in this park than others, and that short fence is just so inviting for hitters. You see a lot of balls bounce over for an automatic double when no one can run it down.
Sedane Rafaela up next for the Red Sox. The 1-1 is fouled off.
He's a little out front, but did a good job keeping the hands back long enough to foul that pitch off.
This one lifted in the air, left field. Ozuna makes the grab, one away.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and was able to stay close.
Here's the second baseman, Vaughn Grissom. The 1-1. And another ball. Man, it's second. And that's ripped to the left. Base hit. Throw comes into third, and they're at the corners with only one out.
All over that one right there. Nice line drive to the pole side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
Now batting Jarren Duran. Kicks and deals. Fastball for a strike.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Two on, one out. On a line out toward center. Squeezes it. Runner tags from third. Throw cut off. Down to the plate. Safe. He beat the tag. And it's 1-0.
Sometimes that can be a little tough to score on. It was hit so hard that getting back to the bag to tag takes a little bit of time by the time that outfielder catches it. But a really good job of getting that run in from third.
Devers now. Two outs. And a foul ball. And now 2-2. Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. One run across in the frame so far here in the last half of the third. Swing and a miss. Had him out front for the strikeout. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. On to inning number four. It's the Red Sox 1 and the Braves nothing. Back now at Fenway. John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Michael Harris. Left-hand hitter waits. That's down and in.
2-1.
Swing and a liner foul off to the right. Puts it in the air out towards left center. He's got it. And there's one down.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
And next for Atlanta, Marcell Ozuna. The 2-1. And another ball.
Oh, they have had a hard time scoring in this one. The pitcher up there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
And he grounds one back up the middle, loves it on the dive, throws from the seat of his pants, and that's a great play for the out.
What an acrobatic play right there. Knocks it down, throws from the seat of his pants, and just looks like he's playing in the backyard. He makes it look really easy.
Here is Matt Olson. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. The 2-2. And that just misses. Austin Riley in the on deck circle. Two down, nobody on. Foul off the plate. They'll do it again. And a pitch. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. Out there to center. Duran moving back for this one. And that'll do it. Four. Leading here's off. The left fielder, Tyler O'Neill.
The left fielder, Tyler of year.
That's outside. And it's 2-1.
You know, these Red Sox showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the...
Swings here and blasts one left field, and it bangs off the monster. Throws to second, and he's there with a double.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. Put a pretty good swing on that one as he drove it out to deep left. Didn't quite have the right combination of launch angle and exit velocity to get it over the fence, but you're never going to be disappointed with extra bases.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Willier Abreu. Man at second. That one pulled foul.
You know, sometimes all it takes is getting to the next arm before an offense does any damage, and that might be the case today.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Try to get him to chase on the changeup that time. Albies tosses to first. One out in the bottom of the fourth.
That's a good piece of hitting right there. It's early, but you still want to put the runner up and give your team a chance to score. That's exactly what happened, so you better believe your teammates are happy with you after that at bat.
On its way to the corner, Ozuna running hard. Couldn't get to it before it dropped foul. And a 1-2. Couldn't chase that time. Arcia jumps, throws, on target. He got him. Nice play. Seeing an impressive jump throw from the hole at short. Let's see what StatCast has to say.
Now he's just showing off out there. I mean, I don't know if fans realize how much arm strength you need to make that throw. This guy's got a rocket of an arm, and that was on full display right there. Just an awesome job.
Now it's Dominic Smith. The 1-1. In there for a strike at the bottom of the zone.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Fights it off, you'll see another. And the right-hander deals. Battling here as he fouls it away. Red Sox by 2. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. And another ball. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And that will end the inning. But they push across one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left on. We played 4. It's the Red Sox 2 and the Braves nothing. And we're back. Down the third baseman, Austin Riley. The pitch. Right through there for a strike. Pitches outside.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff walk.
Swing and a miss, struck him out.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
Adam Duvall at the plate. The Braves trailing by 2, and we're at the top of the fifth. Swing and a miss. Chased it out of the zone.
No fair right there. I mean, that slider didn't move to the very last moment. Incredibly difficult to pick that up. Just going to have to tip your cap on that pick.
He's got it. That's out number two.
The bad out number one.
Orlando Arcia next up for the Braves. Two outs. Late with the swing there.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but.
And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Braves go down quickly here. They trail it here 2-0. Here at Fenway Park, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here now the Red Sox DH, Garrett Cooper. That one outside, 2-1. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Dylan Lee getting loose out there. Chavez also throwing. And he deals. Foul ball. Righty to the plate. And they'll do it again. The 2-2. Lifted in the air right center field. Acuna after it. Corrals it. One up, one down.
The batter. The shortstop. Today.
Zidane Rafaela up next for the Red Sox. Pulls that one foul. The why to kick the pitch. And he walked
him.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches. And somehow, he found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Righty delivers. Rudder takes off. Slow roller to third. Riley tosses across to first. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion. Back to the top of the lineup. Jaron Duran up next for the Red Sox. Siggy, he's got a history of coming through into big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. Runner at second, two down. Last half of inning number five. Just missed.
Well, I think it's the ability to assess the situation, understanding what the pitcher has, what he's trying to get people out on, and then being able to use the entire field.
Next offering is in for a strike.
If you're a guy that can only hit to one field, then you're really not going to be able to come through in clutch situations because pitchers are going to adjust. But because he's able to use the entire field, that's why he's so successful in these situations.
Pitch count's getting up there now, and not saying that's the reason for this walk, but this is the point in the game when every sign of wavering starts to get everyone's attention.
Ryan Snicker out of the dugout, and he's going to make a change. Spencer Schwellenbach will depart, and as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. The new pitcher in the game, Deisbel Hernandez.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
So two on with two away. Rafael Devers up next for the Red Sox. Two on, two outs. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Rafaela on second. Duran on at first with two down. That one way inside.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps he's going to be in the rotation, or maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
Swung on, belted. Acuna raging back towards the wall. And it's caught just in front of the wall. Boston strands a pair as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Now it's the second baseman, Ozzie Albies. In the dirt, and the count is even, 2-2. Struck him out swinging. Long on to first. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Now in for the Braves, Travis Darno. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Red Sox leading it by two, and we're the top half of the sixth. And the pitch. That's outside. Two balls, two strikes. Finish him off.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count off at 2 balls and 2 strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
So the batting order turns over, and now the right fielder, Ronald Acuna Jr. Out towards left center. Duran under it. And that is that. Make it 6 shutout innings for him out there now. It's the Red Sox 2 and the Braves nothing. Back here in Boston, bottom of the 6th. Now the left fielder, Tyler O'Neill.
Tyler O'Neill.
That one just misses, and the count is 2-2.
It's a good take.
Ground ball, Olson. He steps on the bag, one away, bottom of the 6th.
Up next to the Red Sox, the right fielder, Willier.
Willier Abreu up next for the Red Sox. Base is empty, one away, here in the bottom of the 6th. Bounce to the left side, and it goes just foul. One down, base is empty. In the air, out to center. Harris racing after it, but can't get there in time. It's down.
When you flare a ball out behind second base, it's really a tough spot for anyone to get to. And you're never trying to do that as a hitter, but when you do, I tell you what, you're yelling at it the entire way to get down.
And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
That one missed.
Two balls, one strike.
Abreu, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. Hernandez throws over. Abreu back on a dive. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Fly ball to right. Acuna has it sized up. Makes the grab for the second out.
The first baseman, number two, Dominic Smith.
So stepping in for Boston, Dominic Smith. The pitch. Fastball for a strike.
2-2.
Two outs. Blows the high heat past him. That's a strikeout. One left for the Red Sox. They're up 2-0. All set for the start of the inning. Now the number two hitter, Michael Harris. O'Neill on his horse, and he can't quite get there. It's a foul ball. And now the count is even. Action in the pen down there. Chris Martin up and throwing. Number 63 also getting ready. Pop up here, third base side. Devers hauls it in, and there's one away.
So what we're seeing is a lineup that's just out of sync with the pitcher. They're guessing wrong, and their timing's off.
Marcell Ozuna next up for the Braves. The Braves down by a pair here in the top half of inning number seven. Popped up. Rafaela under it. Hauls it in for the out. Two away down.
This pitcher's done a good job of disrupting the hitter's timing with the mix of pitches and changing speeds. You want to keep that front foot inconsistent for the batter. Their swings are hesitant, and that's exactly what you want on the mound.
On the ground, right side. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly.
Say.
Late in the game with the offense trying to play catch up, they're looking for any momentum they can get, any kind of opportunity to get back in this game, and an error can certainly do that. Let's see if that turns into something right here.
Here's Austin Riley. Tying run at the plate.
Well, it's been a very impressive outing so far. His command has been a big part of it. Even when he misses outside the strike zone, which is exactly what a pitcher wants.
The 2-1. And that is the inning. One left for Atlanta. They're still down. It's 2-0. Bottom of the seventh, and stepping in for Boston, Garrett Cooper.
The designated hitter, Garrett Cooper.
And here it comes. Line drive, and that's a base hit out into center field. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got a stride low, out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
At the plate, Sedane Rafaela. That missed by a lot. It's 2-2. And the righty deals. Right back to the mound. Could be an easy two. Over to Arcia. That's one. On to first, double play.
Great job on the mound, fielding his position and making a good throw to second to get the double play started. Far too often, we see pitchers having a hard time with that throw, but No issues right there. That's good practice paying off in a game and resulting in two big outs.
And next for the Red Sox, Vaughn Grissom. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. And so the Red Sox go to the bullpen. Chris Martin.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves. Late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
So here's the Braves' designated hitter, Adam Duvall.
Adam Duvall.
And there's a rocket into the outfield. Around first and hustling for second. Not stopping. He's going for three.
He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
The shortstop, Orlando Arcia. The tying run at the plate. Fouls one away, and now 3-2.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
And the pitch. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Makes the catch for the out.
The second baseman,
Ozzie Albies, up to the plate.
This is all about situational hitting. It's crucial in this spot. Do whatever it takes to put the ball in play, and hopefully you find a gap in the defense.
In the dirt. Wow, that's a great job behind the dish there. Tying run at the plate. Yeah, the 2-1 hammered but foul. Right-handed reliever. And that one is lifted in the air. Durant sizes this one up. He's got it. Here comes the runner from third. Throw is offline, and he scores. And now they trail by one.
Well, that's a quality at bat right there. You know the situation. You need something in the air and deep enough, and that's exactly what he did. Good pass to the baseball.
And now the catcher comes up to him. Travis Darno. Looking to get the tying run on base. And that's off the inside edge. And that's ball two. Up the middle in a base hit, and that puts the tying run on base.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. You see a ball go off the bat like that, you know it's pretty much a perfect swing. And for me, I start wondering, and I'm looking on the computer, what was the exit velocity? This time 106.
And here is Ronald Acuña Jr. In the air, center field. He's under it. And that's the third out. A run on two hits, and they leave one. Home half of inning number 8 straight ahead. It's the Red Sox 2 and the Braves 1. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the 8th, Dylan Lee.
And they felt it was time to bring on a left-handed reliever from the pen with the lefty hitter coming up. I think it's a good move. I know I never liked when opposing teams did that to me.
So the Red Sox lineup turns over. Jaron Duran digs in now.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
And a pitch. That's outside. And it's 2-1.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
That pitch in for a strike, and the count's even at 2.
That pitch started in and ended up on the outside edge, just changing planes and very difficult, especially for a left-handed hitter to track.
Not even close there. Counts full, 3-2.
The guy at the plate could recognize slider out of the hand. Didn't stay in the tunnel very long in terms of depth and perception. He knew right away it was an off-speed pitch.
And down on strikes. And that's the first out. Here's Rafael Devers. Base is empty, one away. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Next pitch is downstairs. The Braves bullpen has some activity. Pierce Johnson getting ready to come in for manager Brian Snitker. The 2-1. That misses off the outside edge. Now fly ball to right center. Harris after it. They got it for out number 2.
Now got left fielder Tyler.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the left fielder, Tyler O'Neill. That one ripped. Ozuna going back. And it's off the Green Monster. In safely with a double, his second of the day.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. He absolutely ripped that ball out front and almost got it out of here, man. Just a really strong, balanced swing. A fraction of an inch different on the bat, and it is probably out of here.
And in scoring position with 2 away. Willier Abreu now at the plate. Next offering is in for a strike. Man on second, 2 down.
2 balls.
In the dirt, blocked. In there safely. So a wild pitch allows the runner to advance. Two outs. In the air, left field, down the line, and that will drop foul. Another 2-2 upcoming.
They're only on that fastball. I'm sure the pitcher taking a note. Look for an off-speed pitch on this next one.
The 2-2 now. In the air, right side. Acuna after it. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. No runs, one hit, a double, no errors, and one man left. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Red Sox 2 and the Braves 1. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Kenley Jansen.
The best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ballgame. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Next offering in there for a strike. Now 1-2.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
The 1-2. Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Pulls it in on the run. One away.
Nothing instills more confidence in a team than a center fielder who makes a great play like that on the run. They can feed off the energy he brings just from his playmaking abilities.
That's inside. One down, base is empty. Right through there for a strike. Kicks and fires. Swings, throw it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, when you throw the same pitch back to back, that's how you want to do it. Set him up in the strike zone, then extend a little bit from there and see if you can get him to chase. Nicely done with the slider right there.
The Braves down to their last out. Matt Olson next up for the Braves. And a swing and a miss. Jansen is just one strike away. And another ball. Two down, nobody on. Got it. And that wraps it up for this afternoon.
Well, a tight 2-1 ball game. Classic pitching and defense in this game. A lot of good execution, and neither team really beat themselves by way of mistakes. But ultimately, it came down to one or two key plays to make the difference for the win.
And your final score here today, 2-1. They hang on to win it by a run. Kenley Jansen picking up the save. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
The final run score for this afternoon's ball game. For the victorious Boston Red Sox, 2 runs, 6 hits, with 1 error.